What the heck is transcoding? Hi, I'm Chris, and I work on the engineering team here in Plex. Today, we're going to go over transcoding and how to get the most out of your Plex Media Server playback experience. Transcoding is taking your video and modifying it into something else. Today's videos are heavily compressed. In order to make any sort of modifications, you need to decode or decompress the video, make your changes, and then re-encode the video into something that client players can read. Plex Media Server may need to transcode your video for a variety of reasons, such as if the player client doesn't understand how the video is encoded, if you're trying to play an HDR video on an SDR TV, if you need to burn in your subtitles to the video because the client player doesn't understand the subtitle format, if you change your quality or bitrate in order to try and reduce buffering. A question we get quite often in the forums is how do you tell if your server has to transcode your video? The easiest way to do that is to look in your dashboard over in Plex Web. If you see direct play listed under your playback session, that typically means that all your server's doing is offering the video to the client as is. If you see that it's transcoding, that means that we're converting from one file type to another file type for some of the reasons that I've talked about earlier. Something else that you need to pay attention to on the screen, if your subtitles are being burned in or directly played. If it's being burned in, that's usually the reason for the transcode. Something else users tend to be interested in is that HW in parentheses next to the transcode. That means that your server is using your GPU in order to encode, decode, and sometimes process the video in between those two. I'm going to go over some tips and tricks on how to configure your server for the best transcode experience. The first thing I want to go over is the transcoder temporary directory. Small temporary files are created as part of the transcoding process. This preference tells your server where to put them. You typically want to put this someplace that has fast read-write access, such as a solid-state drive or a RAM disk. You need to make sure that you have enough space for transcoding, typically equal to the size of the original file, plus around 100 megabytes. Next, we're going to go over the throttle buffer. This is how many seconds into the future that your server will transcode the video before you start throttling back the transcode and allowing some of the other processes to use your server's resources. Those of you with Plex Pass have access to hardware transcoding. This allows your server to use your GPU instead of your CPU to transcode your videos. Hardware acceleration allows for faster transcodes and more simultaneous playbacks, but tends to sacrifice quality for speed. If your server is maxed out because everyone seems to be transcoding at the same time, you probably want to modify the number of transcodes you allow simultaneously. This allows you to maximize the experience for a smaller number of users. Something else that most users want to be aware of is that NVIDIA imposes a hardware limit of 8 simultaneous transcodes. Anything more than that, it falls back to software. The last setting I'm going to go over today is geared towards those of you who utilize software transcodes, and that is the quality setting. Typically, the higher your quality, the slower the transcode, and the more buffering you might see. I hope this has been helpful. Please don't hesitate to reach out to us on the Plex forums if you have any other questions regarding transcoding.